Hey guys, Hisham here from Subliminator, and today I will be showing you how to use our free Photoshop knit action. I'll guide you through the steps to get an end result that looks knitted just like the image I have here. So let's get started. The first thing we'll need to do is load these files into Photoshop. For the pattern file, you go to Edit, Presets, and Preset Manager. From the pull down, you select Patterns and then load up the pattern file. Next, we need to load up the action files. So we go to Window and Actions, which opens up the action panel. Just click on the top right corner of it and select Load Action and load up all four action files. Now you're all set to start applying the action to your designs. What's important here is that you use our PSD template files that you can download from the Subliminator app dashboard. If you don't use the PSD files, the action will most likely not work correct. So I'll open up the sweatshirt template, and I want to work on the front side design. So I've already loaded up one of our free designs just to show you how it works. So here's the design. Once I'm happy with the end result, I just go to the actions window and locate the sweatshirt action. So let me just close these two. So the next step is important for your end result. The design was made in the front side template, so I need to use the front side action. You'll see that there are three options for each side of a product. We have a small knit, medium knit, and large knit. The larger the knit that you choose, the more details will get lost in your design. So my advice is to use the small or medium knit for anything that has a lot of details. And if the details don't really matter in your design, you can go for the large knit. For this example, I'll take the small knit to keep all the details in my design. I just select it and hit the play button. Now the action will do its work, and when it's finished, it will create a new file that you can save and then just upload into the Subliminator app. I'll fast forward this part a bit as it can easily take a few minutes for the action to complete, depending on the speed of your computer, of course. So here's the new file that was created. I can just save this and then upload it in the app. Now let's go to the app and upload the images for the sweatshirt for this design. I've already created the backside and the sleeves design as well. So I'll just select those images and let the engine create a mockup. There you go. If you have any questions after this tutorial, feel free to post them up in the Facebook group or send me a DM. Thank you guys.